On Saturday, December 3rd, 2016, Father Michael Dodds was awarded the Master of Sacred Theology, the Dominican Order's highest scholarly honor. Those who bestowed upon him this honor reflected upon the event.
Father Michael is somebody who has done what the order is called to do intellectually, that is, bring the gospel to the world, make it understood to contemporary society. So, the granting of the Master of Sacred Theology signals to the rest of the order, which is a worldwide order, of course, that Father Michael is one of our eminent scholars.
And individuals have contributed to the theological life of the church and its flourishing by the quality of their life, by their publications, and by their teaching. And in the case of Michael Dodds, of course, he's also been very involved in also popular theology and so forth. So Faith and Reason, the encyclical of John Paul II, faith, bringing reason to bear on faith and faith on reason, that's essential to the task of the Master of Sacred Theology.
I guess I've always had a kind of armchair interest in science. You know, I did science in high school and science for non-science majors in college, but then reading about it and then reading what other people are doing with it was really the impetus to see how that's being interpreted and what new developments are happening. And where it looked to me like the interpretations were not authentic to the science itself. They were introducing other elements and yet not recognizing that, which could make it look like a conflict between science and religion or science and theology. So I saw my work a lot as a kind of work of clarification, going through and figuring out what is theology really saying, what is the Bible saying, and what is science saying as science, and how we put those two together.
The publication of Unlocking Divine Action as a kind of culmination of a lot of work that Father Michael has been doing over a long time, and the evidence that it gives of his engagement in the science and theology dialogue is the thing that showed him to be a true master, in a sense, at even more than one topic, because he had already, of course, proven himself, as it were, in his work on divine immutability.
The order no longer gives it as an earned degree, although as something you have to teach for 10 years and publish, in a way it's an earned degree.
So I was really helped by the Center for Theology and Natural Sciences at the GTU in Berkeley to kind of join in. I'm kind of a latecomer to that discussion, but to join in on the discussion they already had going on for several years about God's action in the world and how science can address that problem. So when I came on the scene, I had a lot of research and material that had already been done that I could simply pick up and carry on from what they were doing. And I think I had a different angle on things too. I was one of the only ones in that discussion, at least at GTU, the Graduate Theological Union, that was using the Thomistic tradition, Aristotle and Thomas Aquinas, and trying to bring that to bear on these questions that others were asking. So I think that was my contribution to that area.